the world of Dr. Dolittle. The wonderful world of Dr. Dolittle. Where crocodiles talk and elephants sing and animals do most any old thing. Where polar bears wear top hats and leopards with spots wear spats. Well, that's life in the world of Dr. Dolittle. Dogs start to coo when they see Dolittle. He has a profound philosophy. If animals can be friends, says he, well then, why can't we?
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. If it isn't one darn jungle, it's another. And I'm getting to be quite an expert on jungles. Who am I? A Matthew Mark, that's who I am. And that was me back there a minute ago thinking about the wonderful world of Dr. Dolittle. A world so completely different from the one you see down there. The one they call civilized. When I'm not in that costume, I'm Anthony Newley. You probably didn't recognize me with the moustache. I grew it for emotional reasons. My mother had one. I've just spent a year in that wonderful world of Dr. Dolittle, who lived and had a thriving practice in the fictional town of Puddleby on the Marsh back in the mid-19th century. We were lucky. We found Puddleby on the Marsh in today's England.
It's Castle Coombe, and it's been called the prettiest village in England. Castle Coombe is pure 19th century, right down to its chimney pots and churchyards. A quaint old, typically British pub, but hardly what you'd expect to find inside.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, Susie.
Cheers, Susie.
There
you go, Susie.
Here, Susie.
That's a clever girl.
The English could scarcely have been prepared for this sort of invasion. A long way from home, isn't she? But she adapts rather well.
Will this frisk around?
That's not the farmer in the dell, but our director, Richard Fleischer, casting animal actors.
Yeah,
yeah.
We've never trained a horse to
jag a leg, one leg.
Horses must think we're absolutely mad.
We should be.
Dick's directed scores of major films. He's become something of an animal expert, and he has to be to direct all the furred and feathered friends of Dr. Dolittle, played by Rex Harrison. They turned this inn into an art studio, and here's where all the changes in the town were planned. Sort of a demodernization process. 1 minute Castle Coombe, the next Puddleby on the Marsh.
Background action.
Background action.
Oh, we're ready here.
The doctor's very smart. He's an Irishman at heart. His favorite color, sure, it must be green. And also, he's a man who'll blarney when he can. Let me explain the sort of thing I mean.
She's a beauty, Samantha Egger. And all of us were delighted to work with this lovely, talented girl. Particularly yours truly, and director Dick Fleischer. If only Rex Harrison hadn't insisted on singing about that infernal rain in Spain. When weather put a stop to filming, we generally found ways to keep ourselves amused. It wasn't too bad waiting things out with Samantha.
I'll show you right now. Because you know, don't you, Samantha? That's what you're born with. That palm is what you're born with. And this is what you ho-ho make of it. No, let me look at your palm. Ah, yes. Here I see a very tall man. He's a doctor by profession. And he can talk to animals. And he's going to take you on a long boat trip around the world for money.
Alias, meine Blumen.
Excuse me, Mr. Newley, you're worried on. Thank you very much. Shall we go, Samantha?
My mitt.
Make some more magic.
I've never seen anything like it.
Neither has anybody else.
Hey, whoa, I say, come here, just a minute. Hey,
honey. It was all sunshine and smiles when we did our big circus sequence. Even animals can be two-faced, as this remarkable push-me-pull-you so ably demonstrates. And Richard Attenborough breaks into song to swear he's never seen anything like it in his life.
I
thought I'd seen every wonder in the world. I've seen the colors.
Leslie Bricus with his lovely wife Yvonne. He wrote the book, music, and lyrics for Dr. Dolittle. But 6 weeks of English rain were just too much for us. Dr. Dolittle and his entourage, man and beast, never stayed put too long in any one place. Mr. and Mrs. Rex Harrison and the rest of us hope now to follow the trail of our friend, the Doctor, from London Airport to a tropical paradise. Some of my best friends were forced to travel steerage class. I decided to join them, but it was no go. And so off we headed for a fabulous island in the sun and a new phase of the adventures of Dr. Dolittle. The sun-drenched town of Castries, capital of that gem of the Windward Islands, St. Lucia. New sights, different rhythms, fresh sounds, colors, odors, a startling contrast to the cold and wet England we'd left only hours before. While we were setting up here for our jungle location, we saw as much as possible of St. Lucia, and no one could get enough of the island's wild, tropical pulse beat. Most of our cast and crew stayed at a palm-fringed hotel right on the beach. With our location a rough 40-minute car ride distance and a mere 10 minutes by water, for Samantha, getting to work was half the fun. For young William Dix, there was excitement and adventure in everything. And no one can blame him if he sometimes felt a bit like Jim Hawkins from Treasure Island. One of the picture's biggest stars is the flounder, Dr. Dolittle's seaworthy home, handcrafted to order. Rex Harrison kept his own film record, which was filled with such touching and vastly amusing incidents as these, each of them highly relivable.
Yeah, don't touch it. Don't start improving it, Alan.
I see this one rope here, Robert.
Twice weekly, our color footage was stowed aboard a Hollywood-bound jet where, after processing and printing, it was returned to us for screening. An 8,000-mile round trip. A location lunch break meant more than just a meal. It brought fun and relaxation.
I'm gonna take a reading
for you. Hey, see, what kind of shine to get up the top of that? Take a reading up the top of that.
Wow, that's worse than the top of the table.
Good heavens.
God, what a plate. Take your spoon. Yeah. Take your spoon. William Dix joins a trainer and a couple of his charges for a snack on the terrace and a lesson in table manners. Are all chimps left-handed or are they ambidextrous? Never did find out. A breather between takes, and producer Arthur Jacobs confers on the script with his director and star. Once more onto the beach, Dick Fleischer, who can't seem to quench his thirst, blocks out a major scene and song with Rex.
We're going to do, if you don't mind, the first four songs.
Here comes the blue one now.
The playback.
Roll it!
Action. Go ahead, sir.
Emma. I think I like it. Yes, I think I do. I think I like you. I'm almost sure that I do. I think I like the way you look. The way your eyes reveal your mind. Like a precious book that is hard to find.
The moment of truth. As our 70mm camera finishes a good take on the scene just rehearsed.
Thank you very much.
The mastery of animal dialogue doesn't come easily. The ubiquitous doctor shows how he's earned his animal degree. And amidst this jungle paradise, a man who talks with beasts and birds lacks neither company nor conversation.
Polar bear and I would curse in fluent kangaroo. If people ask me, can you speak rhinoceros? I'd say, of course. Can't you? I conferred with our furry friends, man to animal. Think of the amazing repartee. If I could walk...
Dolittle isn't one to blow his own trumpet. But with patience and perseverance, any problem can be solved.
And they could talk to me.
It was our great and enjoyable good fortune to have helped bring Dr. Dolittle to screen life, an experience none of us will ever forget. And we like to think that in the hearts and minds of people everywhere, the good doctor will live on forever.
And our white country. All the thunder and beats agree. He has a profound philosophy. And now, why can't we do little things to help them? Why can't we?
I've loved before, who traveled in and out my door. I'm glad they came along. I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before, to all the girls I once caressed. And may I say I've held the best. For helping me to grow, I owe a lot, I know, to all the girls I've loved before. The winds of change are always blowing, and every time I try to stay, the winds of change continue blowing, and they just carry away to all the girls who shared my life, who now are someone else's wife. I'm glad they came along. I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before. Carry me away to all the the girls I've loved before, who traveled in and out my door. I'm glad they came along. I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before. I've loved before, who traveled in and out.